I'm Luke. Today on Out of Darts, we are going to check out the Worker Cheetah. Worker is one of our largest partners here at Out of Darts, and they are constantly pushing into this space. And the space I'm referring to is that of completed blasters. Now, they started this a while back with the Hurricane blaster, the little six-shot revolver, unique magazine blaster. And now they've continued that with offering the Worker Cheetah. In addition to the Cheetah, they now have the Phoenix, which is also on the store. Both the Cheetah and the Phoenix are available now, finally. It did take us several months to get these. Between product delays and production delays and shipping delays, it has been a heck of a year trying to get products in stock, especially from China. The Cheetah is on the surface a single shot springer. The closest thing I would compare this blaster to is a night finder, I suppose, mostly due to the shape. It's got a fairly large plunger tube up top, it fires rifle out of the box, and it's got a couple of different options as far as upgrades and springs, along with ammo types. I think it has kind of a cool look. I actually really like this ammo storage down here. It's really easy to access and throw up more ammo, or even I've found grab a handful of ammo and work those all into that little spot there. It also is a comfortable place to sort of rest your hand, albeit a little bit awkward if you were going to try hold on to this and fire. I think you're more likely to cup over your hand, or maybe hold it up top, or simply aim one-handed. Now, with the stock spring that comes in the blaster will fire rifle rounds at around 85 or 90 feet per second. We'll put the actual test up on the screen. We do offer an upgraded spring, which is what I have installed here currently. With the upgrade, you'll get closer to 120 FPS, which for a rifle blaster is fairly competitive. I'd say the stock version of this is essentially equivalent to a stock knockout, while the upgraded version is sort of like an upgraded knockout. The upgrade itself was fairly simple. It's a single screw to remove the plunger tube itself. The screw was quite stiff, but it seems to be very well designed. Like most Worker products, it's quite overbuilt. The shell thickness on this blaster is excellent. It's got a rock solid feel. However, when we move on to the ergonomics, I do find the grip to be a little bit small. I suspect this was obviously made for the Chinese market. Generally, they're going to have smaller hands on the whole as far as an audience. So I think that makes a lot of sense why this is a bit smaller. But you can see where it sits on my hand here. My pinky kind of tends to hit a bottom a little bit, and the back of my hand hits this little edge on the back. It's not a deal breaker in this form factor because you're probably not gonna be playing super, super long days with this. I wouldn't wanna primary this with this grip, but the feeling and the ergonomics of the grip, other than the size of my hands, is fine. If you had smaller hands than mine, this would probably be a very, very comfortable grip because it is well contoured and has a good feel other than the slightly undersized feel for my hands. Now, Worker does offer a few upgrades for this. One of them is a short dart kit. Now, this short dart kit is a bit awkward. It, first of all, requires you to take the blaster apart and put it in, and you'll notice there's nowhere to load the ammo, and that's where these ramrods come in. And the way you're actually doing this is you're literally muzzle loading this and then ramming down the single shot. I do believe you're gonna get fairly good performance out of the dart kit compared to even the rival, it'll be a lot higher. You've got a substantial amount of air volume and the longer barrel should yield pretty good results. I may cover that in another video depending on the popularity of this blaster and whether people want to see the actual tutorial of how to put that together. Worker includes 6 rival rounds with this blaster. I suspect they didn't make these because in the center of these, I'm seeing a little C, and that's a mold I have not seen before. One thing I have noticed about these rounds is that they are both heavier and more dense than most of the rival rounds, which to me is an actual almost game changer. They're heavy enough that the moment I picked one up, I could feel the difference in weight. and I expect they're going to fly farther and straighter due to the larger mass. These are also going to be available separately, so we will look at carrying these on the shop. For those of you asking about the proton rounds frequently, we've had a hard time competing with Headshot Ammo and some of the other brands that have sort of bottomed out the price on them, though some of that has come up again. So we do anticipate carrying it again, and we will be looking at offering hyper rounds, assuming there is a viable way around the patent and a manufacturer that's able to make them to spec for us. Going through the back of the blaster here, we have an ambidextrous safety. I don't know that a blaster like this needs a safety, but I could see that if this was on your body and you wanted to have it holstered, it would be nice to actually have it in safety so you could pull it off, take your one shot, and move on with your day. The shape of the blaster itself is very conducive to being holstered, so that's a welcome addition compared to some of the funkier blasters like the Hurricane. Overall, this is a really interesting blaster. It comes at a decent price point. It's not game-changing, but I think it's an interesting move for Worker. Now, they've already announced a V2 of this blaster, and it's really not a V2. It is a completely different blaster. It's got a completely different mold, a magwell, and it shoots short darts. So I don't know who at Worker thought it was a good idea to call it a 2.0 when it really is a totally different blaster. And they're going to keep offering both blasters. It's not like this one's disappearing for the Cheetah 2.0. So I'm not sure what the deal was there, but it's really interesting seeing Worker get into this space and offer more ready-to-fire blasters. I think any opportunity we have to see more finished final products that are ready to fire from third-party companies, especially ones that make really good quality products compared to their Hasbro counterparts, it's a win for everybody. And so I'm really excited for this one. I'm glad to have it on the shop, and I'm really excited to have to see the next version as well and see what that does. It is considerably smaller than a blaster such as a Chronos, so you may find that it makes a much more comfortable sidearm. I also appreciate that in its current orange and clear form factor, it doesn't look anything like a firearm, so I would have no problem bringing this to a public park. It would be fairly obvious that this is a toy, and that's definitely a plus. Coming in at $25, I think this is a fairly decent buy. It's not as strong of an offering as some of the other ones, but it is a ready-to-fire single shot from a third party, and it's a very quality piece of design. I'm gonna give this 4 out of 5 stars. I'm really excited to see what they do next. I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments and what other mods you've seen done to this or want to see done to it. Thank you so much for watching, as always. Until next time, I'm out of darts.